Uniondale, New York, and barring a rematch of the 1982 Stanley Cup Final, it's the last ever visit for the Vancouver Canucks to Nassau Veterans Memorial Coliseum. Ryan Miller starts in goal for the Vancouver Canucks. He's got the win in the opener to this five-game trip, a 5-4 shootout decision Thursday at Madison Square Garden. For the Islanders, Yaro Halak comes into the game with 32 wins. That's third best in the NHL. And tied for the franchise record for a season, previously set by Billy Smith, later matched by Chris Osgood, Rick DiPietro, and now Halak. Zach Cassian finished the game in New Jersey with the Sedins, scored a couple of goals to get to Vancouver close. He'll start in that spot for this game tonight. And Travis Hamonic lighting it up from the blue line for the Islanders. He's got 9 points in his last 11 games, and he starts on defense with Calvin DeHaan. Yannick Weber for the Canucks, paired with Dan Hamby, shoots the puck into the Islanders' zone. Brock Nelson back to collect, and he leaves on the corner for Hamonic, who dumps the puck ahead for Cal Clutterbuck. Second in the NHL and hits his Clutter forward line. 19-year-old center for Vancouver's got 8 points in his last 11 games. Turning the puck over is Weber to the wrong guy, Tavares. Turning is Josh Bailey. Swings one on goal, loose puck, backhander stopped as Anders Lee tested Miller from inside. Now throw on goal again, loose in the crease, cleared away by Horvat before Bailey could get his stick on the puck. Off wing, tips the puck to the near side, waiting is Daniel City. DeHaan intercepts his pass. Canucks battle to get the puck back. Here's Cassian from behind the goal. Passes back, speeds up with a drive, puck comes to Henrique. Oh, he put it over top of the net. Halak might have got a piece of it, diving to his left. Henrik Sedin, similar to the goal he scored at Madison Square Garden to tie it, almost gave the Canucks a 1-0 lead. Henrik again off the right side, looking in front. Daniel tips it on goal, and Halak the save, hangs on for the whistle.
I think that might have been Travis Hamonic coming over, getting his stick on it. Hamonic is the shutdown guy now for Jack Capuano and the Islanders. Gets in position and comes over. You can hear a little post. Both of them.
Yeah.
Off the stick, off the glove, and off the crossbar.
Tavares into the corner. Gets a return pass. Tries to get it in front for Nielsen. Puck deflects to Anders Lee, who passes back to Boychuk. Lets it go. Miller the save. Loose puck, and shoveling it back to him is Yannick Weber, so Miller can get the whistle.
Anders Lee planted in front of Brian Miller. It's hard to find the puck. That big body there. Snapshot come through. Lee tries to tip it. And good play by Yannick Weber there, just sliding it back to his goaltender. And I talked about
as Grabatelitz with a long shot that hit Cassian in the front and went wide of the goal. Henrik Sedin from the corner. Passes to Daniel Sedin. Back to Weber. One-timer. Glove saved by Halak. Going down and reaching up. And he held on for the whistle.
Now Hickey does a nice job on Zach Cassian. The Sedins work it back to Yannick Weber, and the shot comes through. Cassian's in good position here. Now he slides away, and Hickey just blocks him out. And okay, your net front presence, you can't get that far over to the side. And Zach is blocked out by Hickey. So really just three sellouts here.
Verbata moves in. Here's Cassian with a shot off the post, and then it went in off the goaltender. Zach Cassian with his third goal in two games, and on the power play, the Canucks make it 1-0.
A long pass to Zach Cassian, and Yaro Halak never gets set. He goes by it, and Cassian just wires it off the post, gets a fortunate bounce off the post, hits Halak and goes in. Good puck movement there, and Zach Cassian, look at the space he's got. And it's off Halak and in. Beautiful shot off the post, and Halak can't pick it up off the post. Hits him hard in the back of the leg and goes in. Reached back with the blocker and never quite got it.
Goal comes 29 seconds into the second period. A power play marker. Canucks are 1-for-1 with a man advantage. Canucks end the streak of the Islanders scoring first in six straight games. And Vancouver gets the opening goal for only the fourth time in the last 15 games. Here's Yannick Hansen trying to move in. Ronnie Kennens chases after the loose puck. He's bumped in the corner. And the Islanders break out. Travis Hamonic to center. Hamonic wide on Hamby. Centers! Unable to make contact with Josh Bailey. Now a chance to the side. Tavares with a shot. Stopped by Miller, who is tangled up with Hanson, and Miller's hurt. Ryan Miller, I think, was already hurt when he made that save. And here comes Mike Bernstein onto the ice to tend to the Vancouver goaltender.
Yannick Hansen's complaining to the referee, saying, okay, why didn't you blow the whistle?
Miller able to stay with it long enough to make the stop, but as soon as he did, the whistle blew, and he just collapsed in the crease.
Hamonic goes wide, throws it across, and Yannick Hansen is the one who catches Ryan Miller. Bailey was going through. And you see Ryan Miller's trying to get up, and Yannick Hansen's on his leg. I think that's where he got hurt. Okay, the neck cam will have a better view of Yannick Hansen crashing into him.
Miller's still down. Face first in the crease.
You can see Ryan Miller trying to get up, and Yannick Hansen was on that right leg.
Crashed into the right leg, and you can driven see backwards into the goal.
He's stretching it out now. Here we'll look at Hamnick going wide. Bailey's going to the net. Yannick Hansen crashes into Ryan Miller, and now you're right, Miller is hurt already. And it's right there that Yannick Hansen, you can see his leg awkwardly go back into the center post. Ryan Miller off to a great start in this game. Eddie Lack looks on.
Looks like he's going to try to gut it out, but not sure he'll be able to. Hunched over and trying to shake it off. One more look from up above.
Watch how awkwardly his right leg goes back and catches into that center post, and he's trying to loosen it to get over to make this save. He's not getting any help from the referee. Able to get his body in front of that one.
He's going to come out of this game. A minute 11 into the second period, Eddie Lack takes over. You wonder if the right leg got hyperextended being driven back. But Ryan Miller unable to continue, and Eddie Lack takes over early in period number two.
There's Eddie Lack tapping Ryan Miller. Obviously the right leg, and you don't know whether that's a groin or a knee the way. And here in Nassau, you have to go to the corner.
Miller been pretty good tonight up till now.
Well, very good, especially the first 5 minutes when the Islanders were all over the Canucks. They had all sorts of room. That was a Grabner shot, the backhand shot in tight. Tavares in by himself. Power play, and he was able to track that one down. And another look at his right leg here, and you see Yannick Hansen comes crashing back as he's trying to back check on Bailey.
Eddie Lack into the game just over a minute into the second. He's 6-7-2 on the season. Third time he's faced the Islanders, 1-1 in the previous two. Just an answer over the Vancouver line. Dishes off, Lee in front. Tavares with a quick shot attempt. Didn't get through. Spezza too slow to move it twice. And it stays in front of the Vancouver goal. What a stop by Lack. He got the paddle down. Wow. And he covers up. A glorious chance for Josh Bailey. And Eddie Lack makes a miraculous save.
Well, Lucas Spezza should go over and tap his goaltender here on top of the head or on top of the pads a couple of times after that one. As you said, John, Lucas Spezza twice had it right in front of his goaltender. Get rid of it. Here's the pass, the shotgun throw. Okay, now get rid of it, get rid of it. Whoa. Get rid of it, get rid of it. Whoa. And here's Eddie Lack.
Oh, it's
Desperado. It hits him in the back of the leg, but he's able to find it after it comes across back of the leg, and he's able to find it there before Bailey can get it towards the goal line.
Bailey took another swipe at it and missed. So it was short. Cassian ended the streak. Here's Verbata moving it. Shoots the puck around. That hit a stanchion, and Verbata is able to pick up the puck. Daniel Sedin banks one around for Henrik. Weber has a good one-timer from the line. He's got the puck. Down for Daniel Sedin. Henrik Sedin. Daniel Sedin. Verbata shoots. He scores. Radim Verbata. Canucks are 2-for-2 on the power play, and they lead 2-0.
Well, that four forward set pays off. It paid off on the first one, Verbata's long pass to Henrik, and then Henrik fed Cassian. This time, Verbata, they cycle it around, and Verbata is the Alex Ovechkin. He gets in the Ovechkin spot, and he's a right-hand shot. They feed it to Verbata, and he just snaps it short side and beats Jaroslav Halak. What a great shot by, not much room at all, about 3 inches, and Verbata finds it.
Canucks' leading goal scorer has his 22nd. And the Canucks, a couple power play goals here in the first half of the second period, jump out to a 2-0 lead. Interesting. This is a bit of an anomaly. Day brings the puck to center on the left wing. Ahead, here's a chance. McMillan is stopped by Halak. Brandon McMillan looking for his first as a Canuck, but couldn't make it 3-0. Puck comes free to Kennens. And he's able to move it to center. Dan Hamhuis rifles it into the Islander zone. Kennens in front. Horvat scores! Set up by Ronnie Kennens, and the rookie's got another one. It's 3-0.
Well, that quick shot, and then Jack Capuano looks up. This is completely against the flow of the play, but it's a good play by Dan Hamhuis on the shoot-in. Hard shoot-in all around. Goaltender can't get it, and who's there first? Well, the Canucks. And Bo Horvat gets the shot. Good shoot-in. Control the boards, and Horvat goes into that good spot for the quick shot. And he beats Jaro Halak. A little bit of a screen. I don't know whether that hit a stick, but Horvat lets the shot go away quickly.
Horvat has his 9th of the year, his 10th point in the last 13 games. And how about the start to Ronnie Kennan's career? He's got 7 points, and this is 11th game. Here's Vyshnovski. Pass up the middle, a good one. Nielsen moves in down the right wing. Drops, and Lack got his glove on that low shot. Just enough to steer it off the side of the goal as McDonald tested him. Here's Colin McDonald again. Centering Lack blocked it, couldn't cover. Puck squirts in front. Cassian gets it, can't move it out. Letty, right point. Boychuk in front, and that one went off his skate and wide of the goal. Islanders pressing here. Down 3. Almost 7 minutes into the third. Boychuk. Behind for Kuhlman. Spins away from Spezza. Kuhlman knocked down by Spezza, who tries to move the puck in. The Islanders hold it in the zone. McDonald checked by Biega. Here's Boychuk. Back to Letty. Long shot, wide of the goal. Nielsen gets the puck on the left wing. Leaves for Johnny Boychuk. No quitting the Islanders or their fans here. Trying to exhort them on here to a third period comeback. Canucks finally get the puck ahead, not out. Boychuk, drop pass, Letty, wrist shot, Lack the save, can't cover, now he does. Might have been a quick whistle as Kuhlman dug the puck free. But the whistle blows, and Eddie Lack standing tall here early in the third. His team still up by 3 thanks to a Canucks collapse back, break it up, and get the puck out. Under 5.5 remaining as Hamonic rushes the puck in. Gets around Stanton. Gets around the net. Feeds the line to Hahn. Into the corner. Tavares. Centering pass. What a stop by Lack. And he gets the whistle. I think that was Bailey in front who tipped the puck on goal. The hard centering pass from John Tavares. And now Daniel Sedin puts Clutterbuck in a headlock. And he doesn't like that. This might erupt a little further.
Yes.
Check that. Martin on the doorstep, I think, deflected that hard pass from John Tavares. And Eddie Lack, another of his series of saves. 11 of them here in the third. And the Canucks on Rogers' hometown hockey are up 3-0. On the Islander power play, 6 attackers for the Rangers. Here's Vyshnovski. Slap shot, Lack the save, rebound. Bailey's after it, takes it behind the goal. Josh Bailey turns in the corner. Shovels the puck to Martin behind the net. 5 seconds to go on the power play. Vyshnovski to the right point. Hamonic with a shot. Lack the save. Loose puck. Another stop by Lack as he denied Bailey coming in off the right wing. And on the whistle, Zach Cassian exits the penalty box. 3:11 to go, and the Canucks survive the power play and still lead by 3. He's standing at the entrance in the corner trying to get back into this game with just over a minute to go. Doesn't look like the Canucks will need it. Up three, and we're into the final minute of the third as Rogers moving in and a shot wide by Clutterbuck. Puck deflects out of play, and that'll give Spezza a chance to rejoin his teammates for the last 57 seconds of this game.
Whoa.
Coaches will appreciate that.
Yes, they will. And the hockey players, you can see Cal Clutterbuck from his days in Minnesota is always a favorite of the Canucks. He's going by, he just makes sure he gets close enough.
Quite the conversation going on right now. And Derek Dorsett doing most of the talking from the Canucks side of things. I don't know if the Islanders are still hot at his run-in with Franz Nielsen in the second period.
Well, and Cal Clutterbuck and Derek Dorsett, and when Dorsett was in Columbus, I'm sure Columbus in the Western Conference then battled with Minnesota.
See some blood on the jersey of Cal Clutterbuck there. And he's not done with his end of the conversation.
Oh, watch here, Kyle Clutterbuck. Look at where his hand is, and then he has the stick in the stomach. And
that was Verbata. He got
spins around,
spear.
And there's Derek Dorsett.
Shot by Strome into the glove of Lack. And a few more seconds off the clock. 51.1 remaining. Islanders. A healthy lead on the shot clock. 35-23. But the combo of Miller and Lack have stopped them all. Hansen gets the puck to the line. Islanders holding it. Chance for Horvat to steal, but the puck got by him. Letty at the right point. Puck gets by Stanton. Here's Bailey. Left point. Boychuk. Rashad. Glove saved by Lack. And a clean look at that one. And now there's 27.3 seconds to go.
Canucks' Ryan Stant did a nice job there. He was in the shooting lane. Jack Capuano's not going to like this one, the way it's ending up. He and Doug Waite. Jack is amazingly second on the Islanders franchise for games coach and wins.
Here's a chance for a shot. Blocker saved by Lack, who stared down that offering from Josh Bailey. Puck is up to center. Matthias trying to get it through to Dorsett, who now gets it on the backhand. Tips it free. Yannick Weber, empty net. He scores. Weber, with 10 seconds to go, makes it 4-0 Vancouver.
It's always nice when you feed that defenseman for the empty netter, and Yannick Weber's jumping up into the play, and you could see the Derek Dorsett. He had a chance. Matthias to Dorsett. Dorsett, he sees Yannick Weber coming up, so he just chips it to him. And Weber on the forehand, no problem.
Yannick Weber from Dorsett and Matthias at 1951. That's his fifth of the season. And one last faceoff. Kuhlman draws it back. And that's going to do it for this one on Long Island. The last Canuck visit, barring a rematch of the 1982 Stanley Cup Final. Eddie Lack combines with Ryan Miller on the shutout. 37 saves between them. And Zach Cassian, another goal. His eighth of the year came on a power play. Turns out to be the winner, as the Canucks have a combined shutout for the first time since December of 2011, when they beat Colorado 6-0.
Well, and everybody contributing. Bo Horvat with his wrist shot goal, and the New York Islanders. It was almost like the New York Islanders, 5 games in 7 nights. Once it started to go south on them, their special teams in particular just couldn't come through, and they resigned themselves to the fact that it wasn't going to work out.
Canucks 2-1 on the road trip now with 2 games to go. They'll travel to Boston after this game here on Long Island, take on the Bruins 2 nights from now. And again, the Islanders back in action the same night as they are home to the Arizona Coyotes. Canucks, 3 goals in the second, lose Ryan Miller to injury. They'll have no more about that moving forward. But again, 2-1 on the road trip as they take it 4-0. Here's Ron McLean in Ouachita.